Good morning, everyone. As we have done in our previous video about exercise 5C, now we are going to start our next exercise, that is 5D. The questions are exactly same as we have done in exercise 5C. You see that what the first question say about it. Convert the following fractions into decimals. What we have to do? We have just the fractions are given. And the fractions, whatever fractions are given, we have to convert these fractions into a decimals. So there is no big deal about it. This is very easy. So let's begin with this one. Okay. What do you have to do exactly? You see that suppose this one is what? 2 by 10. That means 2 is divided by 10. Isn't it? So what we are going to do about it? How we will convert this following fractions into decimal? In general ways, what we do only that we are just going to divide this 2 by 10. So I am just showing this one here, okay. This 2 will be divided by what? 10. So how it will be divided? You see, in the tens table 2 will not come because 2 is very less than 10. So what we are going to do? We will give one decimal here, and this decimal, for this decimal we will be able to get 1 0 from here. So I can see it here easily that 10 2s are 20, I will get 10 2s are 20. So I can get it from here that this 2 by 10, it can be written as what quotient we have got about what? It's 0.2. So this 0.2 can be written as 0.2 because no whole numbers are there. So I have written 0 is present. So 2 by 10 can be written as directly what? 0.2, isn't it? So the thing is that in each and every quotient, here we also have to divide, here we also have to divide, here we also have to divide. So for getting out from these divisions, what we are going to do, I will show you one trick that, and from that trick you will be able to get these things very easily. Okay, so you see that as we have done this one, this can be done in another way also. Suppose like 2 by 10 is given. You see 2 by 10 can be written as whatever numerator is present, no, you just write it directly. Whatever, what I said you, whatever numerator is present, you just write it directly out there. So 2 is written here, so I have written 2 directly. Done. Now the thing is that we haven't converted this into decimal right now. Now we are going to convert this one. We have written the numerator part directly. Now you just have to see that in the denominator part, how many zeros are present. You see that in 10, only one zero is present. No? How many zeros? Only one zero. Just keep in mind, one zero. So we have to put the decimal before one number. So that means 2 was present. No? So it is only number 1. So one, we have to put the decimal before one number. Why this we have put decimal before one number only? Because there was only one zero. You see, so in left hand side of this decimal we can put what? One zero, one whole number there. So this is same as this one. We are going to divide and we will get the same value here, and from here also we are going to give this one 0.2. so isn't that one easy, the tricky formula? Again, you see that if you have any doubt in this question, in number D, it will become very easy. Okay, you see now, what I said you, you don't have to do anything extra. Just write the whatever numerator is present, write that one directly. So 305 was there, 305. I have written 305 directly. Done. Now you see that how many zeros are present in the denominator? 1, 2 and 3. Can you see how many zeros are there? 1, 2 and 3. So from 3 zeros, that means what? We have to put the decimal before 3 number. You see, 1, 2 and 3. So before 3 numbers, I have given 1 zero. Anything to ask right now? So I think if you don't have any doubt, I am explaining this one again. 305 was there, so I have written 305 directly. How many zeros were there in the denominator? 1, 2 and 3. 3 zeros were there, so I have given decimal before 3 number, 1, 2 and 3, that's it. And before that number, you can give 1 0. Isn't that was easy? Okay, so I think, I hope that you have got this. Now we are going to do number E and number H. Okay, so in number E and number H, that is no big difference about it. The other thing is that here it was like simple fractions were given, but there are number E and F, they were present as what? Like those mixed fractions we have got, no, in earlier exercises, that one only. So as I have told you that in between this number and this fraction, this whole number and a fraction, there is always a plus sign. That means they are in the addition form. So just do like this one. 8, we have given plus sign here, and this can be written as 5/100. I have given like this. Now what we are going to do, this 8 will remain same, plus, you see again 5/100, it can be converted into decimal. So how we are going to convert this fraction into decimal? What I said, you just keep in mind that whatever the numerator is present, we have to write it directly. I have written the numerator directly, okay? Now we have to count the zeros in the denominator. You see, in the denominator, how many zeros are there? There were 1, 2. 2 zeros are present here. So since 2 zeros are present, so that means we have to put the decimal before 2 numbers. But I can see that here is only 1 number is present. That means only 5 is present. But in the denominator, there are 2 zeros. So now what I am going to do, we will make it 2 number. Okay. So how we are going to make it 2 number? Suppose this was only 5, that means only 1 number is present, no? We will give 1 0 here. We cannot give another number. Okay, other than 0, you will not be able to use. Only you have to use 0. Okay, so you see, now 2 zeros were present. So I have given 2 numbers here. And as well as soon as I have given 2 zeros here, I can use 1 decimal here. So I can write, you see, that 8 plus 0.05, it can be added directly. 8.05. Wasn't that easy? Isn't it? So, I hope you got this. Again, in number 8, this is the same question like this one. So, again, I am going to explain in that question also. Okay, if you have any doubt in this question, it will be surely explained in that part. So, you see, now this 2 and this 52/1000, it is written in what addition form? So, 2, 5, 2 is there and it can be written 0, 0, 0. Okay, now what we are going to do? 2 will remain same. Okay, we don't have to deal with 2. We just have to deal with the fraction part. So, I have written 2 directly. I will give positive sign plus here. Now, what I have told you, just write the write the numerator directly. So, I have written 52 directly. Okay. Now, what we have to do? We have just count the denominators part. So, you count the zeros in denominator. How many zeros are there? 1, 2 and 3. 3 zeros are there. That means we have to make this. We have to make this number in 3. Why? Because we can put the decimal before 3 number in that part. Isn't it? So you see that 1000, 1, 2 and 3 was there. So 1, 2. Since no 3 number is there, so I will put 1, 0 here. As I said you, that we can use only 0 for making our thing satisfied. So you see that how many zeros were there? I have written 52 directly. But there were 3 zeros, so because of that thing, I have made it 3 numbers, 1, 2 and 3. So since I have made this 1, 2 and 3, I can put now decimal here. And now it is very easy to add this one. 2 plus 0.052, you will write it directly, 2.052. Okay, so I think you have got this. Okay, now copy question number 2. Okay everyone, as we have done question number 1, now we are going to do question number 2. What this question number 2 says, you see, convert the following decimals into fractions. That means it is just the vice versa, that means just the opposite of earlier one. In the earlier question, what was there? The fractions were there and we have to convert those fractions into decimals. Now the decimals are present and we have to convert these decimals into what? Fractions. Okay, so let's see how we are going to do it. So first of all, I am going to remind you some of the place values out there. Suppose I am taking this example as number E. In number E, tell me the positions about the place values. You see that before the decimal, suppose that before the decimal point is present and these points in the left hand side, this one is 1's place, this 3 is in 10's place and this one is in 100's place. What is this? 100's. Now if I am going to in the right side, you see that in the right side what is there? In the points, the first number, whatever the first decimal number is present, this one will be known as 10th place, T-E-N-T-H-S, okay, 10th place. Another one, it will be 100th place, that means this 8 will be divided by 100. This 2 is in what? 1000th place, that means this 2 is divided by what? 1000, isn't it? These things I have said you in the earlier class, so that's why I'm not going to explain this one here. So you just, if you have any doubt, just ask me or I'll show you in these questions. Okay, you don't have to worry about it. So let's begin with number A. The decimals are present, you see that 0.89 is given and we have to convert this 0.89 into a fractional number. So what you are going to do, you just write all the numbers directly. 0.89 is given, no? So we are going to write 89 as a numerator part directly, give a dividing bar, and after giving the dividing bar, we know that these are the decimal numbers are present. So that means they will be divided by what? 10, 100, thousands, like that only. So by how much, by what number that this 89 will be divided? How you are going to do? You just count the numbers after the decimal. You see, how many numbers are there after the decimal? There are two numbers now. So that means there will be two zeros and there is always what? One. So that means this what? This 8 is in what? 10th place. This 9 is in what? This 9 is 100th place. So this will be divided by what? 89 will be divided by 100. So if you have any doubt, just ask me right now or we can proceed. So if you have any doubt, you will be completed in next exercise, next question, okay, number B. You see 41.01 again. So we just have to write this 41.01. This 41, we don't have to deal with anything like this one because they are not in decimal numbers. Decimal numbers are always in the right hand side of the decimal, isn't it? So this 41 will be written directly. You see, we have written 41 directly. And after that, whatever number is present, that means 01 means what? 1 only. So if 0 means 1 means what? I have written 1 directly. I have given a dividing bar. And after the decimal, how many numbers are present? You see, there are 2 numbers now. So that means there will be 2 zeros. How many zeros? 2 zeros, and 1 is always with you. Okay, students, now we are going to do question number A. You see that 132 is in the left hand side of the decimal. So that means we don't have to write do anything. 132, it will remain same, this 132. Now the decimal numbers are what? That is 0.882. We just have to convert this one. So 0.882, we have to write it directly. 882 we have written directly. We will give a dividing bar. And these are how many numbers are present? 1, 2, 3. So this means what? This is how, which place? 10th place, 100th place, 1000th place. So we have to give what? 1000th. That means how many zeros will be there? 1, 2 and 3. So that's what? 1, 2 and 3 zeros. Okay. So again, now we are going to do question number G. That you see, this will be written as what? 8 we have to put directly. We have given 8 directly. So four decimal numbers are there. We have to give 1. And how many numbers are present? 1, 2, 3. How many numbers? 1, 2, 3. So that's why we have to give 1, 2 and 3 zeros are there. So I am repeating this one again. If you have any doubt, you ask me. Okay, you see that this 0.89, this means these are the decimal numbers. So that's decimal numbers are always in what? Division form right now. So 89, this 0.89 we have to write it directly. 0.89 we have written. And after that, how many numbers are there? 0.89, that means number 1, number 2. 2 zeros we have to give. So that's why we have given 2 zeros after 1. Okay. Again, you see this in this one 41.01. So 41 was in the what? Whole number. So that's why we have written 41 directly. After that, 01 in 01 we have to put in the numerator directly. After that, you see the decimal, after the decimal, how many numbers are there? 2 numbers are there. So that's why we have to put 2 zeros after 1. Again, I am saying that how many zeros will be there in the denominator of a decimal number? You see that there will be the number of decimal numbers out there. The same number we will give, because you see that point is there. And after point, how many numbers? 2 numbers are there. So that's why I have given 2 zeros. Okay. Same thing here. 132 is a whole number. So I have written directly 132. This 0.882, I have written 882 directly. And after that, I will give how many zeros after 1? Because there were 1, 2, 3. 3 numbers were there. So I have written 3 zeros. Again, for the same thing, you see that 0.008. So this 0.008 is what? We will write 8 directly. And since point was there, and this will be decimal fractional form. So I have written 1 here, and after that, how many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3. So I have given 1, 2, and 3 and zeros are there. Okay. So now we are going to do question number 3. Okay. Students, you see that in question number 3, what it says, expand the following numbers in all the 3 ways. So that means we have to expand all these whatever numbers is given in the question in 3 ways. So what are these 3 ways? You always have to expand these numbers into, first of all, that is the place value form. Second one is the decimal form. And third one is what? Fractional form. All the forms we have discussed already. So we just have to write it here. Okay. So there is no big deal about it. How we are going to do it? You see. That place value form means what? This decimal number. This 3 is in which place? This is in 1's place. This is in what? 10's place. And this is in what? 10's place. So we just have to write like that one. Okay. So first of all, I am going with this one from the left hand side, most left hand side. This one is in what? 10's place. So we have to write 1/10. Okay. Again, we have to give plus sign. 1/10. This 3 is what? In 1's place. So that's why we have to write 3 1's. Plus this 8 in which place? 10's place. T-E-N-T-H-S. Okay. So that's why we have to write this 8/10. T-E-N-T-H-S. How this this 8 comes in 10's place, 3 is 1 place, 1 is 10's place. These all questions we have discussed in the previous questions. Okay. So again, we have just write it like that one only. This 1 is in 10's place. So 1/10. This 3 is in 1's place. So 3 1's. And this 8 is in what? 10's place. So that's why we have written 8/10. Now, what about the decimal form? So decimal form is also very easy. You see that we have done these questions in our previous classes. Okay. How we are going to do? You see 1/3. So that means this 1, we can break this down into what? 10. So 10 plus, this was in 10's place. No. 1/10 means what? 10 only. 3 1's means what? Plus 3, isn't it? And plus 8 in what? 10's place. So that means it will be after one number. So that means it will be given directly after point. So it's what? 8/10's place. Isn't it? Next question you see about the fractional form. So fractional form is also very easy because this was the whole number part. So we don't have to think about it. This 13 will remain same. This 13 will remain same. 13 plus, we have converted this into what? In fraction. So we have to do the same thing. 8, we have to write it directly. We have to give 1 because it is in the decimal form. Again, after decimal, how many numbers are there? Only one number. You see, 8 is only one number. So that's why we have to give only 1 0. So it can be written as what? 13/8/10. So that's it. You see, place value form, we have to write in all the place values that 1/10, 3 1's and 8/10. Decimal form, we have written 1/10 means what? 10. 3 1's means 3. And 8/10 means what? This 0.8. That's it. Again, fractional form, 13 is in the whole number part. So that's why we have written 13 directly. This 8 is in what? After the decimal. So we have written 8. And before and in upon 10, it will be given. Because why it is upon 10? Because there is only one number present after the decimal. Okay. So I think this question we have done, you have got. Again, we are going to do next questions about it. Okay, so everyone, you see, as we have done one question about it, now we are going to do one more question of it, number F. So it is what? 512.617. We have to write this number, decimal number, into what? Place value form, decimal form, and fractional form. So how we are going to write this in place value form? So we are starting from most left hand side. You see, this 2 is in what? 1's place. This 1 is in 10's place. And this 5 is in 100's place. Now, after the decimal point, this is in 10's place. This is in what? 100's place. And this one is 1000's place. So that's we have only write it. You see, it is on 5 in 100's form. So we have to write 500's. H-U-N-D-R-E-D-S. 500's plus this 1/10. 1/10 plus this 2 1's, so we have written 2 1's plus this 6 in what? 10's place, so we have to write 6/10, T-E-N-T-H-S, keep in mind, okay? Next one, this 1 is what? 100's place, so that's why we have written 1/100, H-U-N-D-R-E-D-T-H-S, 100's place, plus the last one, this 7 is in what? 1000's place, so that's why we have to write 7000, T-H-O-U-S-A-N-D-T-H-S. Okay. So this thing you have to keep in mind anyhow, that this one is what? Tens, this one is hundreds, and this one is what? Thousands. So I have told you about these place values in the previous exercise. So you have to keep in mind. Okay, next, our next form is what? Decimal form. So again, that one we have to we are going to do it also. In the decimal form, you see this 5 is in what? Which form? 5 is in hundreds place, so we are going to write directly 500, plus this one is in tens place, so 1 tens means what? 10. 2 is in ones place, so 2 ones means what? 2. Plus, you see, this 6 is just after the decimal, so that's why we have to write 0.6. plus, you see, this 1 is what? After 2 numbers. You see, after this 6, the 1 is present, so that means in the place of 6 there will be 0. So 0.01. Got it? After, next one, you see, this 7 is present after the 2 numbers of the decimal. You see that in the place of point we will give 0. And in the place of 6 and 1 we are going to write zeros, 1, 2. And this 7 is what? We have to write it directly, this 7. So this is converted into what? Decimal form. Now we are going to write this one is what? Fractional form. So how we are going to write fractional form? This one is in a whole number, so we don't have to deal about it. 512, it will be written directly. This is only in the decimal form, so that's why we are going to write this in what? Fractional form. You see that 512 plus 617, we are going to write it directly, 617. And after that, as soon as the point is present, we are going to give 1. How many numbers are there after the decimal? 1, 2 and 3. 3 numbers are there. So that's why we have to write there how many zeros? 3 zeros. 1, 2 and 3. You see? So it is expanded into what? Fractional form. Okay. So students, I think that you have got this question. After that, copy our next question. Okay, so students, you see that in question number 4, what is given? Write the standard form of each of the following. That means these questions are given in its expanded form that we have done in the earlier question. No? Now what we have to do? We just have to convert this expanded form in its standard form. Okay. So you see that you this one 6 plus 3 by 10, 8 by 100. We have to just convert this one in its standard form. So how we are going to do this? Very easy. You don't have to worry about it. 6 will be written as 6 directly. 3 by 10, as we have done in conversion into decimal form, you just remember that part, that how many zeros are there? 1 zero is there, that means the decimal will be only before one number. So 3 will be written directly, one number is already present, so that means since there was only 1 zero present, so that's why we have to give decimal before one number. That's it. Plus 8, we are going to write it directly. Here are how many zeros? 2 zeros are present, so that means we have to give decimal before two numbers. But I can see here that only 8 is present. For making 2 number, we are going to give 1 0 here, and after that we will give 1 decimal, isn't it? So now just add this one, 6 plus 0.3 plus 0.08. So how we are going to write 0.08? So 6, this 0.3 will be here, and since 0.8 was there, so 3 plus 0 will be 3, and 0.8 it will be there, so we are going to write what? 6.3. If you have any doubt in addition, you see that how we are going to add this one, 6.00 we are going to write, this 0.3 will be written here, and this 0.08 it will be written here like 0.08. Now add this all, 8 plus 0 is what? 8, 3 plus 0 is 3, this point will be in its place, and this will become 6.38 as we have done it here. Okay, now you see that we are going to do question number E. This is also very easy. Just break this down first. So 100 into 5, so it will become what? 500. Plus 9 into 10, it will become what? 90. Plus 3 into 1, so it will become what? 3. Again, 3 into 1 by 10, so it will become what? 3 by 10. Because 3 ones are 3 and divided by 10. Plus 4 into 1 by 10, how much it will become? 4 ones are 4 by 100. So it will become what? 4 by 100. Isn't it? Now we are going to convert these things into its simplest form. So how much it will become? You know, 500 plus 90 plus 3. It will become what? 593. We will be able to get these things very easily. Now plus 3. 3 by 10, it can be written as 0.3. as we have done in earlier questions, how I am going to explain you again. You see that 3, I am going to write it directly 3, okay. 3 I have written directly. Since 1 0 was present in the denominator, so I have to give decimal before one number only. So one number, that means what? 3 is present directly. So we have to give decimal before 3 and it will be converted into a 0.3. Again the same question is there. You see that 4 by 100 is present, so we are going to write it 4 directly. And since what? It is in the decimal form, fractional form, we have to convert into decimal. So you see that how many zeros are there? 2 zeros are there. So that means we have to give decimal before how many number? 2 number. So 4 is already present. That means one number is already there and we have to make it 2 number. So we have given what? 1 0. And after that we will give 1 decimal here. So how much it has become? 593 plus 0.3 plus 0.04. So add this one. 593.00 I have written. This 0.3 point will be written below point. 3 will be here written directly, 0.3. Again you see that 0.04. We are going to write point here, 0.04. Add this all. How much it will become? 4 plus 0 is what? 4. 3 plus 0 is 3. Point will be written here, point. And this will become 395. That means how much we have got? 593.34. So 593.34 we have written it directly. Okay. So students, I think that we have got this. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. But I hope this all you have got. So the exercises that I will give you, some of the questions that you have to do in the class time and send it to me. Okay. So by this, we have completed our this exercise.